Welcome to Office Mechanics, the first show of the season where we go deeper into Office 365 technologies. It's a brand new year and we have a brand new demo-rich show. Today, hot on the heels of the recent Windows 10 announcements, we're going to take a first look at the touch-optimized Office for Windows tablet. Joined by Ben Walters. Welcome.
Great to be here.
So we've had a lot of great announcements around Windows 10 and the preview just being released, but what's new in the world of Office?
Well, this is huge news we have with Office today. We now have Office built from the ground up for touch for Windows tablets. So what this means is no more mouse, no more keyboard. When I'm on the go, I can get access to my Office no matter what I'm doing. So what I'm going to do today is take you through an example of using Office for a photo company who's building a camera. So we're going to go through all of the apps and show you what that looks like.
Okay.
Let's get started with Excel. And here we have some demographic data for where I want to sell my camera and what's happening there. And of course, Excel is one of these really fine-tuned, high-precision type apps today. But now it's really easy for me, just with touch, to be able to do all the things in Excel I love to do. So being able to, you know, select and manage and filter my data, really simple, all just with my finger. But of course, when we're working with Excel, we really want to start to take some of that data and format that so we can present it to people. So over here on my other worksheet, I've got a set of data that's been given to us around book sales for the week.
Okay.
And we can see it's raw, there's no formatting to it, but it's really easy for me to hit the Insert tab and convert this over to a table. And the beauty is, with only one cell selected, Excel can go ahead and figure out the bounds of that data. It's got table headers and actually apply that formatting for me, so I don't need to do all those selection pieces myself. And then of course, once that's done, it's very easy for me to go ahead and start to reformat that, widen columns, move things around as I need to.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, one of the other big powerful pieces of Excel is this idea of charting data and being able to put that into graphs. And we used to do this with a hover control down at the bottom of the table, which, you know, it's kind of hard to do with a finger.
Right.
But here I can go ahead and say, you know what, insert recommended charts, and I get this great live view of the data rendered as it would be in that preview. Very simple for me to go ahead and select those charts.
Great. So now that you've got your data analysis and your research done, why don't you work on the spec in Word?
That's a great idea. So here I have my camera specification up in reading mode on Word. And this is great because it's really easy for me to make my way through the document, see feedback and comments that have come through as part of that. I can also see things like my comments on that document that have done so. I can add review and comment to that as I'm going, as I'm making my way through. And just transition through and read that the way I would read a book. The other great thing around reading mode is this idea of insights. And this is one of the big differentiators for Windows as well. So the ability for me to be able to select a word, have a menu come up, and that menu will give me an insights menu. And what this is doing is looking at the document and looking at the context of what's happening in that document and pulling back additional information for me from the web on that.
We saw that through Office Online. Bing is actually pulling in that information and surfacing that up right in the document.
That's right, and really easy for me to get great rich results in there as well from that perspective. But of course, what I want to be able to do as well is make edits to my document. So I can very easily switch this back to edit mode. And you'll notice I have my document here picked up from where I was when I was reading. Really smooth, really, really responsive in the way I work with that. So with the change in the UI, sometimes it can be difficult to find features that we've had in the desktop and know where they are. And this is where the idea of tell me comes in. So I can start to ask questions of Word around where its functionality is. So for example, here I'm going to go and actually ask for headers and footers. I'll bring that back up. I'm going to ask how I can insert a header or a footer. And you notice as I'm typing this in, it's bringing up those commands. Not help topics or not taking me off to a website to read, but actually exposing that functionality for me. So I can simply put in header, and it takes me straight to the header and footer edit mode, so I can then start to go and put in my headers and footers. Another great feature here is this idea of being able to lock the keyboard. So as I'm navigating through the document, I don't get this happening where the keyboard pops up. Instead, what I can do is lock that out, and then really start to navigate through that document cleanly and easily without much hassle.
That's really cool. So we're seeing a lot of the features from the web services, things like Insights, things like Tell Me, coming down into the rich clients here, Office for Windows Tablet. Now, I know you've also worked on a pitch deck, a presentation in PowerPoint for this camera, so why don't you give us the look of that?
That's right. And one of the big things around PowerPoint when we're looking to review is this ability to really take power of the pen. And this is one of the big differentiators when we look at Office for Windows tablets is the idea that we have styluses that we can use to do real fine-grained control and review on that.
Right.
So here you can see I have my deck, I'm currently in presenter mode, and I can make my way through the slides, really nice smooth transitions, great animations as part of that. But because I have my pen, I can also start to annotate some of this as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see here I have a slide, I've got a couple of bubbles on there highlighting some things, but I really want that to match. So what I can do is I can actually take my pen and start to put in annotations onto that slide to let me know what I need to do. So as I go back and make my edits, I know exactly what that's done there. You know, I can also, you know, cross things out and have that in there. I could also use this while I'm presenting if I wanted to highlight different areas of the deck. So if I wanted to draw attention over to certain things, I could go ahead and do that as well.
Right.
So with my annotations in place, I can bump out of my presentation and get the option to keep those annotations as well. So I know exactly where those marks were made and what they look like. One of the other things we've got is this idea that I, you know, wanted to try and copy and paste my formatting over. It was one of the things we noted down that we wanted to do. So historically, this is something that would take a mouse and a keyboard and the copy formatting function to do that. Mm-hmm. But now I can go ahead and do this with touch. So by selecting the object I want to copy, we get this little ellipsis that gives me a submenu. These are all contextual and will show up based on what I have selected, and this menu will alter as I need to. So I can go ahead and hit copy formatting, select my new object, and paste that over there. And there we go, I've now got consistent formatting across my deck. So again, really powerful, really easy to use these touch-based applications.
Really great. So we see a lot of the web services coming in to support that. We see the power of the pen on Windows 10 especially is a real differentiator in terms of some of the things that you can do with that device in specific. Great in terms of all the functionality we have across all of your documents, your spreadsheets to plan out your camera that you're building, the specification in Word, the PowerPoint file. The great thing is it's really consistent across all the different tablet form factors you're using. So whether you're using iOS or Android or Windows tablet, you want to make sure that you can be able to change from one platform to the other very easily in just offices, wherever you are, and as the device that you have on you, right?
That's right. It's really important. And, you know, in the camera world, we say the best camera you've got is the one that's in your pocket. And now the best device I have is the one that I've got with me.
That's really great to see. Thanks for joining us today, Ben. Of course, you can follow all the news on the Office blog and on Wednesday's Office Mechanics. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.